Hello. I've been working on a workshop character. That's right. I'm a liar. Roll the clip.
I'm probably not going to be able to make Arrivals of Aether character. Most of you are not going to be able to make Arrivals of Aether character.
I'm not actually wrong, exactly. The thing is, making a workshop character is a shitload of work. It's very tedious. There are a lot of things involved, but I decided to hunker down, be a real gamer. So I'm not done yet. You can see here, this is what I have done. Right now, as of recording this, I only have the idle animation. I can walk, I can turn around, I can crouch. I've been working on the run animation. Hopefully more is done by the time this video is actually edited and released. And I have basically all the major mechanics coded. So like all the complicated stuff about this character is actually done. It's now just a matter of filling everything in and just fleshing out all the moves. So what this video is going to be about is I'm going to go over the whole process of what it's been like to make a character. I've been doing it for 3, 4, 5 weeks now. I've been doing it for quite a while. I've been just loving it. It has been an absolute blast going in and just making this character. So I just want to talk about my feelings, what it's like, what the overall experience is. This is not a tutorial. I've never done this before. I've certainly made many mistakes along the way, and I will continue to make mistakes. But it's been a lot of fun. So in this video specifically, I'm going to talk about just the design and what that's like, designing the character. And then in future videos, I'm going to talk about the coding and the pixel art, which is basically the trifecta of making a workshop character. So yeah, let's get started. I've probably already shown you some actual pixel art of what he looks like, but here are my initial drawings before we ever saw anything of this character. This is what he looks like. Yeah, the actual ball on the tail actually came out during the pixel art process. I was like, oh yeah, this would actually make sense in the way this person would look. But anyway, Dinoc. So where we started, many of you may know, I love Yoshi, specifically Melee PM Yoshi, because the movement and the double jump armor is awesome. I really like how Yoshi functions in Melee and PM, and it's kind of gotten completely lost in the later Smash games. Going and playing those, it's something that's not in Rivals at all. It's like, hey, why not bring it to Rivals? Because I want to play as Yoshi everywhere I go now. So that's where we started with Dinoc. Yoshi, but not. Also, Dinoc, where I got the name. Dinosaur. Rock. Dinoc. I know, it's amazing to watch a genius at work. Rock, I got from the double jump armor. Armor. Rocks. Rocks are like armor. Dinoc. Genius. I didn't want to just translate Yoshi one-to-one into Rivals. The idea is, what if Yoshi were a Rivals character? Kind of like Claren and Rano were sort of, you know, it's like the Rivals version of Marth, the Rivals version of Sheik. What if the Yoshi was in that DLC pack? What would a Rivals-y Yoshi look like? So that brings us to the main mechanic of Dinoc, are these armor points. I figured that double jump armor might be extremely broken in Rivals, since defensive options in general in Rivals are toned down. Double jump armor, naturally, might be busted. I don't know, but I decided to tie it to a resource. So that way, if it did turn out to be busted, it'd be very easy to limit the possibilities. But if it's not busted, it'd be easy to just like beef it up. It's just like tying it to a resource, I think, gives me more control over how double jump armor will function in a match in terms of like after the character is done, how I can patch it to make them better. In Rivals code, there is like something like double jump armor that already exists. Edelus Fair actually functions the exact same way. Rivals calls it soft armor, is what I learned when looking at the code and people telling me and stuff. So anyway, armor points. The idea is he would have specific instances of double jump armor. So like when he's in double jump and he gets hit, when he lands, or when the double jump ends, the armor point goes away. He's got to use his resources to gain more armor points so he can keep that advantage. And it adds a level of counterplay, right? If you can shut Dinoc down by stopping him from getting these armor points. Aerials, basically almost exactly the same as Yoshi. I do want to make his drill Maple Drill. Rest in peace, Maple Drill. And so what's interesting about Dinoc, what's interesting about Yoshi, and why I like him so much as a character is because he's got such a small little change in just his basic movement that makes him completely different from every other character, which is the fact that he can turn around when he double jumps. You'll see Jigglypuff and Kirby, I believe, do this. I'm not sure if anybody else does. I have no idea. I don't play the later Smash games. They have a trillion billion characters. So like that in and of itself, whatever. But then Yoshi's got the other thing of double jump canceling. If you don't know what double jump canceling is, Apsa has it in Rivals. Basically, certain characters, their double jump actually smooths downward at the beginning of it and then goes up, which means if you do a move, During the downward portion of your double jump, you cancel your double jump and basically just goes down straight. So combining that with the fact that you can turn around with your jump creates a really cool thing with Yoshi, where you'll see he'll jump in one direction, double jump cancel back, and bam, he hits you with a nair, and then you complain on Reddit or whatever. But it's really cool. It's a completely unique form of movement, and as if you watch me at all, you know I love unique forms of movement, and that's why I like Yoshi, and that's one of the main things I wanted to capture with Dinoc. Another aspect to Rivals character design is that all Rivals characters have what I call a spatial resource, as in some kind of thing that is out there on stage that is separate from themselves that they can go and grab, gain advantage from, or put disadvantage on the other player. For Dinoc, I'm calling it the Rock Totem. The idea is he's going to plant this totem, this little rocky thing, that he can interact with in a bunch of different ways. Typically in Rivals, your special resource has synergy with your specials. So Dinoc can use his side special on it, he can use his neutral special on it, and his down special is what creates it. He can even throw his Yoshi-like egg thing at it to explode it to do, you know, larger area of effective damage, right? The idea is, like, this is this object that's placed that both players have to think about. Like, how do you counter it? How do you gain advantage from it? This Rock Totem is also going to be one of the main ways Dinoc gains armor points, right? He's going to eat the totem, gets up armor point. So that's like the effective cost of double jump armor, right? There's setup on the front end that gives him an advantage on the other end. So Dinoc's side special is going to be interesting. Something about Yoshi that you see, especially in the earlier games, in Melee and PM, Yoshi doesn't gain any height from his up B, which is typically the main way you gain height in Smash to recovering it back onto stage. In PM, Yoshi's side special gives him like a little hop. Like in Melee, his side special is basically useless. So I decided, hey, why not tie it in to the armor point system? Something that I have to keep in mind with Rivals is there's no ledge, so not having any type of vertical recovery I think might be way worse, right? Because if Dinoc uses double jump, wall jumping is not going to help him get back onto stage necessarily. His air dodge maybe, but it's going to be an extremely terrible recovery. So I'm putting in a risk versus reward system. The idea is his side special without armor points does like this dinky little grab. It gives him a little bit of horizontal distance, but if he hits an enemy, he'll get like a little vertical jump. Sort of similar to like Diddy Kong, but like not as extreme and not as good. But if he does have armor points, he gets a much farther horizontal boost. And the main thing is you can press the special button again to gain a vertical boost, sort of like Eliana, but not as extreme. The downside is you lose all your armor points. So that's like the risk reward part of it, is you could get this vertical boost, which you might probably will have to use, but you no longer have the armor to just get back on for free. And also if you hit your totem with your side special, you don't lose your armor points and you blast off and can hit your mom. Sorry, mom. So another thing with Rivals that they have is a common design thing is unique states. Neutral special, the way it interacts with the totem, as I talked about before, is you can swallow it, gain some armor. Or if you don't swallow it, Dinoc will hold the rock in his mouth and it'll slide forward, and he can do an armored smash attack. Very similar, basically stealing the idea from a pre-existing rival character, Edelus. Or you don't have to do the smash attack, and you can just, if you delay your swallow of the rock, you just get a crazy burst of momentum. So specials in Rivals, they tie to your mechanics, interact with your spatial resources, and they should always provide movement as well, right? Like Edelus Ice slides you around. I wanted to have something for Dinoc, right? And so that's where his neutral special is. It's kind of like Rano's tongue also will like fling-flong you across stage. Dinoc's neutral special will do a similar sort of thing, but it's like a grounded slide. So it's like kind of combining, you can come from the air into a grounded slide with this neutral special. Just to give you more options, right? The idea is like, I don't know how this exactly will be used, but it sounds cool. So now that we got all those specials and crazy mechanics out of the way, his grounded normals, pretty much Yoshi, except I did want to have a little bit of more synergy. I might do this with all of his attacks, or just at least a couple more of his attacks. Right now, currently, in my mind, his up tilt would be a normal Yoshi up tilt. But if you have an armor point, it'll be another move where you'll shoot a little projectile just to like empower your normals. Just I want to have different ways because decision making is fun. So I want you to constantly be thinking like, should I save my armor point to be defensive, right, to tank a hit later? Or should I use it right now to like continue this punish in a stronger way? Having a normal gain special benefits from the armor point mechanical synergy, hopefully really fun. What I'm most worried about looking at Dinoc's design like going forward with, you know, when this character gets done is something that you can't really know until it's tested with a lot of players, is how the economy of these armor points will work. Will they go away too quickly? Is Dinoc going to be struggling to get them? Or is he going to have them too much? Is he going to, like, always have double jump armor? I don't want either thing to happen, right? You want, like, a balance where he's always just has, like, enough that he needs, but he's always in kind of a place where it's like, I gotta get more. Eliana's theme is like a great example of like having a really good economy in terms of like how this meter is spent. Sometimes you're shooting, but other times you're in overheat. Sometimes you need to go into overheat. Other times you wanna get the fuck out of overheat. Get out of there. So that's what I'm aiming for with Dinoc's armor point. So yeah, hopefully, you know, sounds really cool. If you have any suggestions or whatever for Dinoc design, throw it in the comments. I think it's a pretty solid design though. Looking at it, like, I think really captures the Rivals design because I'm a genius. I don't know. We'll see. Like, one of the main things about making a character going into this is that, for me anyway, what's made this really fun for me is having the mindset of, like, nothing is sacred. Everything could change at any time. I think that's something you have to go into. If you're too rigid in your design, you're gonna wind up disappointed no matter what. Like, things just won't work out the way you expect. And so I look at all of this as just like a guide. Like, this is like the goal I kind of want to achieve, but how I get there doesn't really matter. And that helps with like the tremendous amount of work this all is. I think just going in with the mindset of like, yeah, I'm probably gonna have to redo all this no matter what, makes it like less, I don't know what you call it, less like exhausting when you do a whole bunch of stuff and you're like, oh, I guess I do have to redo all of this. Yeah, I already expected that, so it's A-okay. And so yeah, that's basically the design of Dinoc, more or less. A lot of stuff will definitely change in the future, and I'll keep you guys updated on that. And so yeah, this was fun talking about it, since it's my own character and I've been obsessing over this damn thing for a while. And so I look forward to hopefully making another video or two where I talk about the actual coding and the pixel art, which are both, like, humongous processes in and of themselves. And if you want to see the development of Dinoc in real time, I've been streaming the whole thing on my Twitch. And yeah, that's the end of the video. If you want to join the awesome people you see on screen now, you can sub to me on said Twitch or support me on Patreon. Video, like, algorithm, subscribe for more videos. Thank you all for watching. Flippity-flappity.